all the hopes and promises given, and the pain that life gave me will be our will and commitment to face.
With the best of Coachella.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on.
Just one moment, we'll have the entrance of the From this moment, I have been blessed. I live only for your happiness and for your love. I'd give my last breath from this moment on. I give my hand to you with all my heart. I can't wait to live my life with you. I can't wait to start.
Have the entrance of the Mini Ride, please.
You and I will never be apart. My dreams came true.
The Mini Bride, and then the ushers will close the doors, please. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand to your feet and let's celebrate the Lord God with a hand clap for this occasion. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, as you look to the rear, you will see our bride, Miss Lucy Barbara, as she makes her entrance into her wedding ceremony. Amen.
I don't know how you found me, but from the moment I saw you, deep inside my heart, I knew. With all my heart and soul,
I give my love to heaven home.
And as far as I can see, you were always meant to be my destiny. Give my love until the end of time.
But forever was just a word.
Just a word.
Something not only heard about, but now you're always there for me. When you say forever,
this bride in marriage. Groom, take your bride. Remain standing for the opening prayer. Let us pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the privileges of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your Spirit. Work in the lives of these two people. We give you the praise, the honor, the glory for the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives to bring us into a place of union with the Father, union with the Son, union with the Holy Spirit, and union with one another. We thank you for it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Give me a resounding amen. Amen. Come on and say amen. 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 You may be seated.
This will be the charge to the bride and the groom. As I read scripture from the fifth chapter of the book of Ephesians, I want you both to pay very close attention to the words stated here. They are the words from God's word that the Holy Spirit will honor as we stand on them in faith. The world has the idea that marriage is simply a legal contract. It is a legal contract. We don't make light of that. But at the same time, it is a spiritual contract. When the words of faith are spoken according to the word of God between two born-again believers, the power of God goes into operation. There is an actual miracle that takes place when the faith of these two people is released in God's power. God honors their faith and brings them into union together. With these thoughts in mind, listen very carefully to these words. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot, wrinkle, or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself, for no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth, cherisheth, even as the Lord, the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and shall be joined unto one flesh. This is the great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. So to the groom, sir, have you accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and personal Savior?
Yes, I do.
I have.
Yes, I have.
Good. And to you, Sarah, again, have you received the Holy Spirit to dwell in you?
Yes, I have.
Praise God. And to the beautiful bride, Lucy, have you accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and personal Savior?
Yes, I have.
Amen. And Lucy, have you received the Holy Spirit to dwell in you?
Yes, I have.
Praise God. To the bride and groom, now upon public confession of your faith, you have made known to all men that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is your Lord and Savior. I make this announcement before this congregation and these witnesses. When two people join themselves to the Lord Jesus Christ by faith, according to God's own words and God's own statement, they stand cleansed as clean before God as Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden before they sinned. This is not just a forgiveness of sin. The Bible says any man who is in Christ is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and all things have become new. A miracle took place when you made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. The Holy Spirit used the same power of God, His creative power, to cause your spirit to be reborn. It is the same power that God used when He raised Jesus from the dead and joined you to Jesus by that power. When two born-again believers come before God to be joined together as husband and wife, the Apostle Paul calls it a mystery and says, "But I speak concerning Christ and the church. When you made Jesus the Lord of your lives, you were joined to Him." 1 Corinthians 6:17 says, "You are one spirit with Him." Here in Ephesians, it says that you have become one flesh with the Lord. You are His and He is yours. You are one together with Him. I want you to understand that if you rightly discern the body of Christ, then you rightly discern the miracle that took place in marriage. Your spirits will be joined together and you will become one. You will not be one just in the eyes of the law. There is something much more powerful that happens. The very creative power of God will join you together. Do not tamper with the union. The love of God doesn't say, "I love you, but do you really love me?" The love of God says very simple, "I love you." That's all it ever says. Do not tamper with that miracle. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath. Something holy, something beyond reproach, will take place by the Spirit of God inside of you, and it is a precious thing. Amen.
Someone excited, clap more hands for together for Jesus. Please let the bridesmaids and the groommen please to have their seat. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus. Charge to witness and congregation. To every one of us witnessing, to witness. I want to speak this to the witness here. Jesus said in the 18th chapter of Matthew's gospel, "Again, I tell you that if two of you on earth agree about anything you ask for, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven." You are not here just because of tradition. You are here for a serious purpose, to hear witness forever to the miraculous union that will take place, and to add your agreement before God to that which takes place. From this day forward, regardless of what comes, you are in agreement with this union. Don't ever attempt in any way to cause it to be anything other than a happy union. To the congregation, in the eyes of Almighty God, these two people are washed in the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They have prayed, and before the Lord God Himself, they believe with all their heart that it is the perfect will of God for them to be joined together in spirit. They have made their decision. So from now until the end of this age, I charge you to do anything in your power to see that this union remains solid and strong, happy and prosperous. Woe to any person who will tamper with it and cause it to be anything other than precious in the eyes of God. This is a miraculous thing, and it is of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're excited, can you shout hallelujah? Hallelujah? You know, when we were in Sunday school growing up, there are some songs we like to sing and we never forget them. And even though we sing them in church, growing up, most of you probably know the song. The way you're looking this morning, you're looking so serious. This is a happy day. If you're happy and you know, say ha ha. If you're happy and you know, laugh until your neighbor is asking why you happy. If you're not laughing, you are a suspect. So can you please, camera, can you help me take the groomsmen? They are looking too serious. See, the okay, I was going to ask, how can men be comfortably seated when the women are not yet seated? Who does that? Africa. Sorry. Not Africa. Please let one of the groomsmen make room for the ladies. You let the women sit first. No, right there, my brother. Yes, you. No, right there. Uh-huh. So that the lady can just go and exactly. So move. That's right. We have to model honor and respect for women. If you agree with me, clap your hands. All right. Good. So, okay. Thank you for that sacrifice. So we need to, I thought we have a seat for him already. So Minister Edward, please, let's move one of the seats there, from there. There, you guys can just, let's make a quick adjustment so that he can sit where he wants to sit. Amen. Now, if you're happy and you know, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know, give a smile. If you're happy and you know, and you really want to show that you're happy and you know, say ha ha ha. Say amen. So this is a beautiful day. This is an amazing day. This is a glorious day. And it's not a funeral service. It's a wedding. And so some are looking so serious. Maybe they're hungry or they're angry or they're both. Because an hungry man is an angry man. So, so tell me, which one are you? Are you hungry? Are you angry or are you both? So they are hungry and angry. Okay, so do me a big favor. Let's suspend the anger. Throw the anger somewhere for now, but just maintain the hunger, okay? And let's do this as fast as possible. What do you think about, sir? Isn't he looking really like model? You see, my wife was very partial. When she said, now, sir, to you, I was listening. She just called him by his name. And when it was the wife's turn, she said, now, to the beautiful bride. You see how partial women are? She didn't say to the handsome man. So I'm here to defend the cause of men. To the handsome man. So he's a model. Make sure after this, you go and put him in Time magazine. That's a prophecy, so I say I receive it. All right, God bless you. We want to welcome every one of you. This is a joyous moment. This is an amazing day. This is a beautiful day. So we want you to be as relaxed as possible, because the Bible says in the presence of God, there is fullness, not partial. Fullness of what? Joy. So you must rejoice in the presence of God. So we want you to be relaxed. We want you to be excited. And we want you to be expectant. Because as this miracle is taking place, whatever miracle you desire, you will receive yours today in Jesus' name. Amen. Can I hear a good amen? Amen? So look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. This is a beautiful day. I'm glad you're here. You are blessed to be part of history. So relax. Cheer up. If you don't cheer up, if you are not happy, I will move away from you. I promise you. Do you want me to move? Okay, now give your neighbor a high five. I say, I'm staying because you're a good neighbor. Amen. Can we rise to our feet as they play that wonderful song, Sarah and Lucy? Let's watch how you bring his bride up for the exchange of the vow. Amen. They're going to give us something. You'll dance, we'll celebrate as they come up, as he brings her up. I don't know. Can you?
He is giving me victory.
So bring them up. Bring
your wife up.
Let's rise to our feet and shake your body. Please land, rise to your feet.
Everything that I have now, you gave to me.
That's right. Bring her on.
Lord, I say, for your love, I'm grateful. Yes, you love me plenty. You came to die for me. Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nissi, I am the
Oh, hold it. Hold it. I beg you, permit me to do something right. That's not right. Please, go back. Did I just see you let the woman climb this thing? Is that what you are learning in this church? Is that what you are going to do to her? He never married you. He did not let the woman climb step by herself. That's not right. No. You're going to go there and bring the woman up. Yes. Go back again. And madam, allow the man to spoil you small now. Hey, this America has affected some of our women. They are hardworking and they are independent and they just want to do things, and which is good. Amen. So, but now you have to do it. You hold a hand. You see, the father is still there. If he changes his mind and he takes the woman, I won't beg you. All right. So that's not how you hold the hand like this from there. What is your possession? Yes. So when she's climbing, make sure you are making sure. You hold, you're sure. You climb, she climb, you climb, she climb. You are leading, she's following. Okay? All right, give us that music. Let's do it again.
There's no one else like you. I love Judah. You're the man, the man, the man. God, in your grace and mercy, is always the follow me.
Are you celebrating?
Hallelujah. If Jesus has given you victory,
heavenly blessing I may receive.
Somebody shout hallelujah. What a faithful God we serve. This is a beautiful day. I am super excited. You see, this is a testimony of what the power of Christ can do. What the enemy meant for evil, God made good, bringing them closer and closer and closer. And now they are really swearing a covenant. You don't enter. I was telling them during the counseling, prior to now, all those 19 years, he should have escaped. Now you are swearing before God. So the good thing is that it's a good trap. But it's not really a trap. It's just a blessing. Because one, it's making the woman happy. She feels like, oh, I am now there, right? I'm sure looking at all of you, she's feeling so special. So this man is a good man. Clap for him. But you know, in every good man, there is one bad thing. You understand? This joke is not too good. So if you are too sensitive, help me close your ears. Okay? Several years ago, I was teaching in a youth conference. And there was this, during question and answers, there was this young lady, very smart, very intelligent. She raised her hand. And the good thing is that she was intelligent. She was a virgin. She had been all good and everything. So she asked a question. She said, I have a question. You know how smart girls like to act. So I have a question. I said, yes, I'm listening. She said, when it comes to marriage, I really want to say, I'm not going to marry any man that is just anyhow. Because, excuse me, I can't take, if you don't like to hear it, close your ears, okay? I can't take shit from no man. Did I say close your ears? Okay. You know what they call it shit? It's here that it looks so big. You know, back home, that's what we call it. Nobody saw what they call her. Now, so they call her now. So, but the guy said, I can't take shit from no man. And I stopped. And I said, okay, if you can't take shit from no man, it means you will never marry a man. Because every man got some shit in him. So, the fact that this man got some serious stuff in him, and this beautiful lady endured, she stayed with him, and now she's entering into covenant with him. Clap for her. Help me clap for her. Are you borrowing those hands? See, I'm suspecting all those bridesmaids. You like the man? These chief bridesmaids, these bridesmaids, they are not clapping. And in wedding, if bridesmaids are not clapping, suspect them more. All right, clap for her. She's such a wonderful woman. I'm so proud, privileged, and blessed to be called their pastor their spiritual father and guide. It's been a journey. There has been the challenges of life, but to watch them weather all the challenges, break down the walls and feel the valleys and level the mountains and straighten the crooked paths, and they keep pressing until today is a reality. I'm so grateful to God. This goes to say that if you truly put your heart to make anything work, it will work. If you really want things to work, they will work. And I don't know who you are in this place that need a miracle, you need God to just step in, you need God to make things better for you. You see, the good thing about God is that he knows everything about us. So it's only foolishness for you to hide yourself from God. You have problems and troubles and you are hiding from God. God already knows. He said, Adam, where are you? Adam was busy hiding. God said, I know where you are. So what is there is, when you come to an atmosphere like this, you have to believe God for a miracle. You're not just here to witness a wedding. You're also here to receive a miracle. You will receive your miracle in Jesus' name. Please, one more time, I want us to clap our hands as we celebrate the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Savior of the world. Let's thank God for this wonderful day. Amen. That's right. Do that again. Do that again. That's right. That's right. I like that. Who else can do that? Who else can do that? Do that again. Do that again. Do that. Aha. Uh-huh. That's it. That's it. That's it. Somebody go wild. Wahoo! Wahoo! Now be seated. See, the winning camp is always the shouting camp. Yes. Have you ever watched game, soccer, football, anything? The people that are losing are always like this. They look as if they are eating lemon. Their faces as if they carry bags of cement. People that are losing are never happy. But people that are winning, you see them, hey, they are dancing. So the dancing or the winning camp is always a shouting camp. So in this church, we shout a lot. We dance. This is not a mortuary. This is a sanctuary. So when you come here with loads of headache and problem, by the time you get in here, if the pastor has not removed it, somebody sitting next to you will remove it. And if you are sitting next to somebody who doesn't remove sorrow from you, change your seat. We always have permission. So when you are sitting beside somebody who is looking too serious, that seriousness is not original seriousness. So maybe they have one problem or the other. So make sure you remove that sorrow from them. Touch your neighbor and say, I'm glad you are sitting beside me. I will remove all your problems now. In Jesus' name. Amen. This is a beautiful time. We're going to be exchanging vows. Now, to the groom, sir, do you take Lucy as your wife, as your own flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her and care for her for the rest of your life? If you do, say, I do.
Yes, I do.
The guy has added yes. Now turn to her and make this confession of faith. Hold her two hands. Please. This is your gown. You better tell people that it's my company that made this gown so they can come and buy it from my company. Now, please make this profession of faith to her. Say, Lucy.
Lucy.
I, sir. Before the Almighty God.
Before Almighty God.
And the court of heaven.
And the court of heaven.
I covenant with you today.
I covenant with you today.
To be a godly and a loving husband.
And a loving husband.
As an act of my will.
As an act of my will.
and desire of my heart.
And desire of my heart.
I choose to guard.
I choose to guard.
Protect.
Protect.
And bless you.
And bless you.
Nourishing you.
Nourishing you.
As my own flesh.
As my own flesh.
I will be your covering.
I will be your covering.
You will be my glory.
You will be my glory.
I will love you.
I will love you.
With the love of God.
With the love of God.
For you.
For you.
I will be patient.
I will be patient.
I will hope all things.
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 Believe all things.
Believe all things.
And endure all things.
And endure all things.
I will not keep a record of you of wrongs.
I will not keep a record of wrongs.
I will never violate this solemn covenant.
I will never violate this solemn covenant.
Fidelity.
Fidelity.
Honesty.
Honesty.
And loyalty.
And loyalty.
Will ever guide my thoughts.
Will ever guide my thoughts.
And actions.
And actions.
I will pray for you.
I will pray for you.
Knowing that.
Knowing that.
Only together.
Only together.
Can we inherit.
Can we inherit.
God's grace of life.
God's grace of life.
Above all else.
Above all else.
I will strive.
I will strive.
I will strive.
I will strive.
To be a man.
To be a man.
After God's own heart.
After God's own heart.
Knowing that.
Knowing that.
And only that.
And only that.
Will make me.
Will make me.
The husband you deserve.
The husband you deserve.
Let's put our hands again. So just in case someone is waiting for better, for worse, in sickness, in death, we don't do it in this church. Okay? Yeah, marriage is a blessing, not a curse. So all the blessing we are giving here, it's empowering them to defeat sickness, wars, and all those things. Now somebody is asking, well, what if things go bad? The blessing will correct the bad. You understand? So if he's sick now, does it mean she will leave him? No. Because sickness and disease is not part of the blessing. The blessing crushes sickness and disease. If you want to know who God is, look at his word and look at his character. He's a good God. So when you are listening and you're not hearing for better, for worse, in sickness, in death, in hell, and fire, and no, we don't do it here. We profess the blessing, and the power of the blessing crushes every curse. So the covenant is a covenant. And what you believe is what you will experience. Say amen. Amen. Well, don't leave your hands yet. Now, to the bride. Lucy, do you take Sir as your husband, submitting yourself to him as the head of this union for the rest of your lives? If you do, say, I do.
Yes, I do.
Clap your hands. I've been privileged to do over 1,800 to 1,900 weddings. And I can promise you that on the we've had a few situations where on the wedding day, the lady said, no, I don't. So when you hear a lady say, yes, I do, don't take it lightly. If the hands that you have are not borrowed hands, you have to jam them together. So she just said, yes, I do. Can we just celebrate them? Before you have stories that touch, she said, no, I don't. It becomes something else. But God is faithful. Now, Lucy, look straight into the eyes of your husband. And make this confession of faith. Say, I, Lucy, before the Almighty God,
before the Almighty God,
and the courts of heaven,
and the courts of heaven,
I covenant with you today, sir.
I covenant with you today, sir.
You're looking at your wife. To be a godly loving wife.
To be a godly loving wife.
As an act of my will. As an act of my will.
As an act of my will.
And my desire of my heart.
And desire of my heart.
I choose to respect.
I choose to respect.
Honor.
Honor.
And bless you.
And bless you.
Responding.
Responding.
To your spirit-led.
To your spirit-led.
Headship.
Headship.
Of our family.
Of our family.
I'll be your glory.
I'll be your glory.
You will be my covering.
You will be my covering.
I will love you.
I will love you.
With the love of God.
With the love of God.
For you.
For you.
I'll be patient and kind.
I'll be patient and kind.
I'll hope all things.
I'll hope all things.
Believe all things.
Believe all things.
And endure all things.
And endure all things.
For you.
For you.
I will not keep record of wrongs.
I will not keep record of wrongs.
I will never violate this solemn covenant.
I will never violate this solemn covenant.
Fidelity.
Fidelity.
Honesty.
Honesty.
And loyalty.
And loyalty.
Will ever guide my thoughts.
Will ever guide my thought.
And action.
And action.
I'll pray for you.
I'll pray for you.
Knowing that.
Knowing that.
Only together.
Only together.
Can we inherit.
Can we inherit.
God's grace of life.
God's grace of life.
Above all else.
Above all else.
I will strive.
I will strive.
To be a woman after God's own heart.
To be a woman after God's own heart.
Knowing that.
Knowing that.
And only that.
And only that.
Will make me.
Will make me.
The wife you deserve.
The wife you deserve.
Can we put our hands together for the Lord? Best man, can I have the ring, please? Thank you. Where's the other ring? Let me. So, I'm going to ask you guys to join us in officiating this. I need you for the next 1 minute or 60 seconds to stretch your hand forward. And bless this ring. If you have any good thing in your mouth that you want to see in your life, say it. Because anything you say will come back to you. So if you say something bad, ready for 1,000 fold. If you say something good, ready for 1,000 fold. Go ahead and bless the ring now. In Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we purify this ring from all forms of impurity. It is blessed in Jesus' name. Thank you. A ring is a very precious thing, a token of your faith and of your love. This ring is made out of precious metal. It is a never-ending circle that indicates the continuing love of God. A love that never fails. God's love endures long and is patient and kind. God's love is never envious nor boils over with jealousy. It is not boastful or vain glorious, does not display itself haughtily. It is not conceited, arrogant, and inflated with pride. It is not rude, unmannerly, and does not insist on its own way. God's love does not insist on its own way. For it is not self-seeking. It is not touchy or fretful or resentful. It takes no account of evil done to it, and it pays no attention to a suffered wrong. The love of God and the faith of God is what causes his power to move in your life. I want you to wear these rings as a continual reminder of faith, a continual reminder of the confession of faith you have made to each other and to God. The word of God says, above all else, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. If anyone could break up this union, it would be Satan. So, it is your responsibility, according to God's word, to give him no place. So give no place to the devil. This marriage is forever. Say forever. Now take this ring. Put it on her. A thumb. Sorry. Put it on her. Okay. Yeah, put it right there. Okay, good. All right. Say to your beautiful bride, with this ring,
with this ring,
I did wed.
I did wed.
It is a token.
It is your token.
It is a token.
It is a token
of my love for you.
Of my love for you.
And a token of my faith.
And a token of my faith.
That I release now.
That I release now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. To the groom, a ring can mean two different things. It can be a never-ending sign of love, or it can also be a shackle, like a chain. I'm going to charge you with a memory you should remember always. This woman stands by your side, not under your feet. You have the responsibility of being the head of this union. You have the spiritual responsibility. I want you to wear this ring in remembrance that she is your helpmate. It must never be a shackle of dominance, but always a reminder of faith and love. Amen. Clap your hands for Jesus. All right, to the bride. Here's the ring. Please, I want you to place this ring on his finger with this in mind. Think about this. There's no place in the Word of God that gives people the right to dominate one another. Your vows have stated that you will submit to one another in the responsibilities of life, expecting God and his power to always make the difference. So, place this ring on his finger, and as you do, don't look at the ring, look at the Lord of the Rings. Is he still the man?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good. Now, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I did wed.
I did well.
It is a token of my love for you.
It is a token of my love for you.
And a token of my faith.
And a token of my faith.
That I release now.
That I release now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Somebody say amen. Amen. Can we put our hands together for the Lord? Wow. Wow. Now, Pastor Janet is going to lead in the prayer and administration of the Holy Communion. So we can go straight to the this.
To the bride and groom, both of you as believers have received the communion table in the past. You know what it means, but I want to remind you that we live under a covenant with God. This covenant was ratified by the shed blood of Jesus at Calvary. Now we see something new that has never existed before. When you were born again, each of you became a new creature in Christ. The two of you together have become a new creature in Christ because you are now one. When you agree on things, they will come to pass. Can we say amen?
Amen.
You have an awesome power at your disposal. When you're going to notice a new realm, you are going to notice a new realm of your life beginning because of the spiritual law that says one can put 1,000 to flight. From this time forward, your everyday life will be 10,000 times more powerful spiritually than ever before. It is important that in this first moment together, you honor the Lord, honor his table. Jesus said, "This is my body broken for you. Eat of it." We'll give the couple the bread.
Hold on, Pastor Bright is coming. Clap your hands for Pastor Bright. Bring the tip. Bring the tray, please. Wonderful. This is a good blood covenant.
Woo!
Amen. Okay. All right. So you can take. Now you can leave her for a minute. So you can take. Yeah, you two grab one.
His precious body bore your sins and carried our diseases. The two of you together in the name of Jesus Christ have the God-given power to ward away sicknesses, diseases, the storms of life, and everything that hell would offer any marriage. Through this broken body, you have received into your hand the awesome power of the Almighty God. Jesus also said, "This is my blood that ratifies the covenant. Drink of my blood, and as often as you drink it, do it in remembrance of me." As you drink, I want you to remember what he has done for you. I want you to remember the covenant that he has made available to you, the power that he has made yours.
Amen. So usually we either use one cup or something. So there's something working with this great couple. There's something I know that we are trusting God as we continue to serve God. I want them to understand the power of serving each other because this is a great couple. Clap your hands, they are amazing. So what we're going to do is we're going to ask the wife to grab one, so I would grab one. So you will serve each other the communion. You ate the flesh of Jesus. You're going to drink this as a symbol of your covenant together. So you serve each other. Just don't mess her dress up. Otherwise, we'll send it to go and buy anyone. All right, so grab it. Yes, you two grab that. So we're going to do it together at once. I wish the cameraman give this to a little so people can witness this. Okay, you know what? So you don't want to lose that, right? Okay. So now, you go nice and gently. Don't unveil the thing completely. Just look for a way to send it under. So lift it up. Look at her. So you look at him. Get closely. And now, when I say you can drink, then you can stop. I need you guys to help me see who is a better servant. Okay? And if you saw, If it's Lucy, Lucy, Lucy. If it's both of them, both of them. Or Salu, Salu, Salu. All right. Now, drink the blood of Jesus. Whoa. Oh, wow. I don't know. Okay. I think that in this case, there is not a single winner. They are both winners. So we can call it Salu or Lusa. So Salu, Lusa, Salu, Lusa, Salu, Lusa. Somebody say amen. I want you to stretch your hands and just bless this couple. Open your mouth. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, let this covenant speak for them in heaven, on earth, under the earth. When wicked powers rise to fight them,
Let such powers
scatter.
If witches and wizards
try to destroy them, let their evil plots backfire seven times.
Father,
because of this covenant, let your face
to
shine upon them,
and upon their household.
Everything they do
from this day
will excel,
will succeed,
will prosper
because of the support
of God.
Let the angels of God
fight their battles. Let the angels of God bring their blessings. Let the favor of God protect them so they can grow old together and will be extremely
successful.
Their children will be mighty
upon the earth.
This family
is forever.
They will succeed in Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
All right, let's put our hands together for the Lord. Amen. Now, the next thing on the agenda is the message. But because of the time we started, they were supposed to go back to their seats, and then I share a message for 15 minutes and bring them back. But I want to skip that. However, I'm going to leave them with this one word from the Word of God. You see, now that you've done this, you have to understand that you are not going back to a house, you're going back to a home. There's a difference between a house and a home. A house is what you buy. A home is what you build. Building a home has nothing to do with bricks. It has everything to do with the bricks of your character. So here are four building bricks or building thoughts I want you to have. Number one, you must remember that whatever you want high, you must first dig deep. The depth of the foundation will always determine the height of the building. So, if you want this marriage to go high, then you must invest your time in digging deep. Lay a solid foundation for yourselves. And the solid foundation, the Bible makes it clear that Jesus is the foundation. And why is Jesus the foundation? Because he is the rock that never fails. Every other ground is a sinking sand. So you must build upon the Word of God. You must allow the word of God to control your feelings and your emotions and your actions and your attitude. That means maybe when your wife does something wrong and you tell your friend, and your friend say, if let me be that, I for slap him. Waiting. Now, the word of God is against that. And I personally love every man. But I feel like any man that will raise his hand against his wife, beat his wife, slap his wife, hit his wife, is a baby. No, not baby. He's a bomb boy. He's a bomb boy. They should give him feeding bottle. You understand? Give him feeding bottle. Let him be drinking milk. Warm the milk for him. Because that's childishness. Because if you think you're a man and you are powerful, go out and meet another man like you. Right? Or come to me. But the fact remains that sometimes women, their mouth is anointed. Chey! They can talk. If you listen to everything a woman says, you will go mad, though. So, what should you do? Build on the word of God. And you see, the greatest thing the word of God asks us to do is to forgive. So, you can operate a law called the law of advanced forgiveness. Amen. That means I have so much forgiveness in me. Before you offend me, I have forgiven you. So by the time you are offending me, the offense expires. It has no place to stay in me because I have forgiven before the offense showed up. So build it on the word of God. Forgive each other. Don't listen to bad counsel. The lady that tell you, you mean your husband did that to you? All these men, No, don't listen to that anymore. Right now, you are in covenant. Serious covenant. So, the only way you can both succeed is you must build on the word of God. So, the word of God says to forgive. Most people think that love is what makes marriage fail. It's not true. Love has never sustained a marriage. Love is a living organism. And when it is fed, it lives. When it is starved, it dies. I'm sure there are some amazing fathers in this house. There are some of these fathers, some of you are sitting with your wife, and if that's your first wife or your second or your third, somehow you have some wisdom to give to us. You will tell us that, listen, no matter how much you love a man or a woman, there will be some time that the love won't look like love. Especially if the love is based on your feelings. Feelings fluctuate. Today you feel good, tomorrow you don't feel good. So if feelings is what sustains your marriage, that means you will marry 70 times before you die. Because the woman you think is an angel of God, suddenly you discover that, I always say, people like honey, but they forget that is bees that make honey. So sometimes the honey that you call your wife, you should remember that bees makes honey and bees stinks. So when your wife or your husband stinks you, you don't run out of the marriage. Because I don't think he loved me. If he loved me, he wouldn't have stunk me. That's why it's not love that sustains marriage. Love helps marriage, but what sustains marriage is commitment. So, building bricks, when you lay foundation, three things. Number one, commit yourself to each other. Be committed to the marriage. That means if rain falls, sunshine, tell yourself, we ain't going nowhere. One day my wife looked at me, and my wife said, you are stuck with me. And I thought about it. I said, yeah, that's true. I'm stuck. So when you discover that you are stuck, then you have to make the stocking work. You have to make the most, otherwise high blood pressure, hypertension, diabetes, you don't need all of that. You want to look young when you are 70. I don't know about you, but at 90, 97, I want to go and play lawn tennis. So you see, you can't allow every problem to weigh you down. You must be committed. We are in this for life. Can you repeat it? Let me hear. Say, we are in this for life.
We are in this for life.
Look at him and tell him. Say, we are in this for life.
We are in this for life.
I don't hook you.
I don't hook you.
Tell me, I don't hook you.
I don't hook you.
You ain't going nowhere.
You ain't going nowhere.
We are in this for life.
We are in this for life.
Say commitment.
Commitment.
Brick number two is consideration. Say consideration. It means you must always consider one another. Nobody is perfect. Put your spouse in your shoes sometimes. So that means when she goes and she work overtime, undertime, all the time, and she come back home, you don't sit down and say, hey, honey, I'm waiting for my food. So you have become the lion of the tribe of your house. Or you are the king of the house. We know that. But you consider her. I'm the pastor of the church. But sometimes I consider my wife. I go into the kitchen to cook my own thing. She cooks all the time. But sometimes when I look, if I wait for this, hunger will catch me too much. So I go in, I prepare my thing, and I enjoy my life. I make sure my life is simple. All this mentality that says a woman is your slave or your housemaid, your house girl, I hate that, you know. I had six sisters. Every guy that came to marry my sisters, I warned them. I say, I'm a spiritual man. I pray, God hear my prayer. Go and ask my enemies. Go hear my prayer. Oh yeah, if you try me, I fry you in the spirit. And I have that power. I don't abuse it. But if you touch my sister, I will fry you in the spirit and physically. Uh-huh. I used to box and I still box. So if you make it that I have to come to your house, you're in trouble. Now, why am I saying that? Because sometimes men, unfortunately, some men have developed a mentality of slavery. They are so incomplete within themselves that the only time they feel good and complete is when they turn their wives into slaves. Oh, that's in Africa. In America, it's the women that turn the men into slaves. Oh, sorry, did I say that? I didn't say that. In Africa, men beat their women. In America, the women beat their men. What a life. So that means you must consider each other. That means after this wedding, all the money this guy has spent, don't go back and say in 2 weeks, can you buy me that car? No. Consider each other. Maybe there's some debt he has to pay. Because everybody is going to be happy now. They will go to your wedding and they will eat all the money. Maybe some $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 that they might have spent. He has to recover that money. So consider him when he works overtime. So they go, where are you now? You are working. I thought we just did covenant marriage. We should be enjoying each other. We have to pay the debt. Oh, we borrow money. Consider. Say consideration. Consideration. So put your spouse in your shoes. Your life will be happy. You will be so happy. And finally, communication. Communication. Now, I'm a prophet. I see things. I hear things. I know things. But still, there are some things about my wife that if she doesn't tell me, I probably may not know. I will be busy seeing vision for people, prophesying and praying for other people. And then she may be angry. My husband is not. He's not. Why are you mad? Communicate. Talk to each other. That's what it means. The most stupid thing you can do is to talk to outsiders about you. Your own come bad. When we say you don't already get four children. 19 years old. So by the time you talk to people, you are creating complications for yourself. Does it mean I should keep quiet? Develop friendship that everything secret stays within you. Because all the people you are talking to, they have their own battles. Oh, they have their mountains. And yet, talk is cheap. Work is hard. They have their mountains. When you tell them, my husband say, ah, that's your husband. If it's me, if my husband say, ah, I will say, ah, ah, ah. Go back and see. When the husband sneezes, she's hiding on that chair. She's lying to you. Don't believe them, oh. It's not everything you see that looks at its look. Walk your own marriage. Communicate. Talk to each other. I didn't say talk at each other, because that's a problem. Many people talk at each other. Wife wants to talk to the husband. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. When will you pay the bill now? When will you? You are talking at each other. That will ruin your family. I've had some foolish women say, men have ego. Well, my assignment is to break his ego. If you break your man's ego, he will become your houseboy. And if you sleep with your houseboy, you are a stupid woman. Right? All the men wave your hands and say, yes! Because I'm telling you, it's the ego of a man that makes him a man. If you say your assignment is to break your man's ego, my wife is there. I mean, I take care of my family. This is America, I know. But I take care of my family. 100%. Pay every bill. Sometimes she's feeling sorry for me. My husband, and she's telling everybody, I'm getting shy now. My husband does all this thing for her, so we don't want it to be too much. And when she tells them, then she come and say, I told them my husband does all this thing. And 3 minutes later, I say, honey, can you do this thing? So they are still taking the hotel. But here's the thing. What is it that makes a man want to take care of his family? One, God. Two, ego. So by the time you break the man's ego, you will look for another lady that build his ego, and he will pay attention to that lady. That's why you can see professors of university sleeping with their house girl that didn't even have a GED. Why? Because the house girl made them feel like kings. So women, if you make your husband feel like king, he will buy the world and give it to you. But if you make him feel like your houseboy, then he will wash your clothes and you will never have fulfillment and satisfaction. But then, so if you talk, don't talk at each other. Sir, she's not your house girl. Don't yell at her. Bring my food. Wait, why are you? No, it's not the best. So control your emotion. Don't talk at each other. Talk to each other. If there's something you don't understand, since you are not the Holy Spirit, you have Holy Spirit, she's not Holy Spirit, tell the person, you see this thing you said to me, I'm not happy about it. Instead of piling up emotions and then one day you have an outburst, talk. When you feel bad, I'm feeling bad. When you are okay, you say things. Above all, the strength of communication is praise. There will always be bad things and there will always be good things. Is your responsibility to choose what to see. If you choose to see the bad things, the Bible says that if a king decides to listen to everything his subjects are saying, he will hear his own servant curse him. Whether you like it or not, if you're a king, your servants don't like you. Some like you, some don't like you. Some wish they were the kings. They are in your place. So the Bible says, don't pay attention to everything people say. Because one day you will hear what you really don't want to hear. So instead of that, look for the good things in each other. Shower yourselves with praise. Communicate praise. As you are living, whisper to her ear. Babe, I don't know say you fine like this. Oh. Tell her. When you are at the... I love this man. He's ready to do everything right. And since the time I met him until now, he has changed. He's becoming a better man. So talk to each other. Praise each other. After this, after honeymoon, create another honeymoon part two. You rent the hotel. Pay for the hotel. Say, honey, I want to take you out for all the money you spend. Let me go and spend on you. Take him out, minister to him. Let him call his mother from the village. Hey, mama, oh, this wife is spoiling me. Let him enjoy you so well. Because they are children, I won't say some bad things. Otherwise, do all the necessary, all the adults, just on that, all the necessary stylus. Say stylus. That's right. If you understood that, say, Yeah, give him good something, you understand? Food is good, but satisfy him. No. Let him be happy. Oga, let her be happy. I believe that under God, this family will succeed. This marriage will progress. And as I'm talking to them, maybe you are single and you are expecting God to bless you with a husband, good man, good woman. I pray for you that that good man will come, that good woman will come. And maybe you're also here. Your marriage is in crisis. You are suffering. You are regretting. Did I marry honey or did I marry bee? Well, do I have roses or do I have thorns? The good thing is that roses have thorns. So I won't look at the thorns. I will look at the beautiful flower. So I'm praying for you that maybe you have had a failed marriage or maybe you've had crisis or perhaps you're going through pain right now. Your husband is causing you pain. Your wife is causing you pain. Jesus is the healer. So I'm praying for you using this marriage as a point of contact. And I pray and declare over you and over your household that there will be healing for your marriage.
Amen.
There will be miracle in your homes.
Amen.
There will be miracles in your life.
Amen.
If you believe it, say amen.
Amen.
Somebody that needs a new beginning, I pray for you that you will have a new beginning in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Some other person that is saying, I don't think my life will ever work. I want you to know, with Jesus, there is no impossibility.
Amen.
Nothing is impossible with him. Absolutely nothing. So I want to pray for them. And before I pray for them, I want to pray for you. Can you close your eyes for a minute? You cannot have the blessings of God if you don't have a relationship with God. So I want to pray for somebody as we're leaving this place now. I want to pray for somebody who wants to start a relationship with Jesus. And maybe you are feeling guilty, full of sin. You are feeling ashamed. Or you just are confused. You don't know what life is all about. But today, you want to start a relationship with God. Can you raise up your right hand? Please, no noise. I want all eyes closed, all heads bow. Thank you. Oh, wow. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you, sir. God bless you, sir. God bless you, ma. God bless you, ma. Wow. God bless you, ma. Wow. This is amazing. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Wow. Look at the bridal trend. God bless you. Now, take that same right hand and put it on your chest and repeat after me. Say, Heavenly Father, I thank you for your love, your mercies, your forgiveness. Today, I confess that I am a sinner. I cannot help myself. But I also believe that Jesus, you died for my sins. On the third day, God raised you up for my justification. So now, I receive your forgiveness. I renounce the devil and all his works in my life. I receive the forgiveness of God. I receive the love of Christ. I declare I'm a child of God. Holy Spirit, come and dwell in me. Help me to live for God all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, Father, I pray that upon the confessions of these ones, that your grace, your favor, and your power will rest upon them. Holy Spirit, we know that you can walk on everyone that have made this confession, that has made this confession. Now, perfect your work in their lives. As they leave this place, let them remember that they are new creations. Tomorrow, let them remember. All the days of their lives, let them remember. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Now, blessing the union. If you can stretch your hands, please stand to your feet, everyone. Let's bless the union. Pastor Michelle can come up to get ready for me. All right, please kindly stretch your hands. In Galatians chapter 3 says that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, so that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might be heirs of the promise of the Spirit. Now kneel down. Please, pastors, can you guys come around? Come, Elder Mercy. Let's come and surround them. Pastor, come on. Pastor Melody, come on, Pastor. Yeah, I mean, come on. Let's surround them. Kneel down, please. Help your wife to kneel down. Don't forget. Thank you. Okay. Is there any other pastor here? A pastor from another church or anything? Abel, come and join us. Is Mr. Kelvin here? Where's Kelvin? All right. So is there a pastor? Okay, good. All right. So please. Wonderful. Please. Let's stretch our hands towards them. 1 Peter chapter 3 says, a man and his wife are heirs together of the grace of life. I'm going to read to you your blessings, your inheritance. Please listen carefully. Please, people, as I read it, I'd like you to join and scream amen. Can we practice amen? Amen means I'm in agreement. Amen means so let it be, or so shall it be. Amen? Amen. According to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1 to 14, you get all of this there. The Bible says all these blessings will come on you and overtake you if you will hearken to the voice of the Lord your God. Now, are we ready? You will be blessed in the city. Amen. You will be blessed in the country. Amen. You will be blessed when you come in. Amen. You will be blessed when you go out. Amen. The Lord will grant that your enemies who rise up against you will be defeated before you. If you are not an enemy, shout a good amen.
Amen.
They will come at you from one direction, but they will flee from you in seven directions. The Lord will send a blessing on everything you put your hand to do. The Lord your God will bless you in the land he is giving you.
Amen.
Then all the people of the earth will see that you are called by the name of the Lord.
Amen.
They will fear you.
Amen.
Then all the people of the earth will see and understand that the hand of God is upon your lives.
Amen.
The Lord will grant you abundant prosperity.
Amen.
You will have wealth, riches, and money beyond the wildest dream.
Amen.
You will own houses, properties, businesses, conglomerates in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will grant you abundant prosperity in the fruit of your womb.
Amen.
The young of your livestock.
Amen.
And the crops of your ground.
Amen.
In the land he swore to you, even in North America, South America, Africa, you will prosper.
Amen.
The Lord will open the windows of heaven.
Amen.
The storehouse of his bounty. The Lord will send his rain of blessings upon you.
Amen.
The Lord will bless the work of your hands.
Amen.
You will. I love this. I love this. Please, everyone, stand to your feet. Please, everyone, stand to your feet. If you're here for the wedding, stand to your feet. If you are carrying a baby, it's okay. You can sit down. Madam, you can sit down with the baby. But all of you men that you are not pregnant, please stand. And all of you, thank you. Okay, beautiful. Tell the young girls around to stand. All these beautiful ladies. Where's Naraya? All of you stand. Good girls. Thank you. Stand, okay? Yes. We are the last part of it now. So this one is very good. As I pray for them, it's coming upon you too. You will lend to many nations and borrow from none. Amen. You will be a lender, not a borrower. Amen. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. Amen. If you pay attention to the commands of the Lord your God that I give you this day and carefully follow them, you will always be at the top and never at the bottom. Amen. The Lord will establish you as his holy people. Amen. As he promised you in an oath. Amen. As you keep his commandment and as you walk in his ways, you will prosper, you will excel, you will go forward by this anointing. I confirm the blessing. Amen. By the release of this anointing. Amen. I confirm the blessing. Amen. I lift you up to experience the fullness of the blessings of God. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Let the church shout the resounding Amen. Pastor.
Praise the Lord. So now I'm going to address the bride and the groom. So I want to speak to both your hearts. I charge you both as you hope for happiness in your married life to be true to these vows you have just made with one another. With your marriage, from this day, you begin life anew with larger responsibilities. Sir, guard well this your bride who now commits herself to you into your keeping, and so live in the Lord that no word or deed of yours shall cloud her brow with grief or dim her eyes with tears. Amen?
Amen.
Lucy, it will be your part to retain by your virtues the heart you have won by your graces. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And now to both of you, I would say, let not your voices lose the tender tones of affection, or your eyes forget the tender way with which they shone in courtship days. You know when you guys was... It is the privilege of both of you to delight in the company of each other, to remember that in interest and affection, you are henceforth to be undivided. Amen?
Amen.
It is your duty to preserve both your duties, not your family, not your friends. It is your duty to preserve always the fidelity of this union. Amen?
Amen.
And greatest of all, let God be enthroned above all else at all times. Amen?
Amen.
And may the congregation say amen.
Amen. Well, for as much as Sarah and Lucy have consented together in holy matrimony and have witnesses the same before God and this great company, I have declared and have declared by their faith, by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, therefore becoming one in Christ, I declare by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel, that this couple is husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the law of the state of Illinois. Amen. In the name of God the Father.
Amen.
In the name of God the Son.
Amen.
And in the name of God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
May the Lord make his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
May he be gracious unto you.
Amen.
May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you.
Amen.
May he give you peace both now and forevermore.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor, privilege, joy, and excitement to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Kwikwa.
Hallelujah!
Hey! Somebody go ahead and make some joyful noise! This is the moment everyone has been waiting for.
Yes.
You're going to unveil your bride to be sure she's the same person that all these bridesmaids didn't exchange her. Please, no movement, no noise again. Yes, hold it now. Shut the door. Sir. You may now unveil your bride and kiss your bride. Somebody shout! Wow, what God has joined together, no devil can put asunder.
Amen.
Automatically, sir has put lipstick now.
Hey.
So ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank you on behalf of this great couple. We want to thank God for your lives, and we thank you for your patience. We thank you for your support. We thank you for your prayers. And I believe that you're going to have more than enough food to eat, to drink, to dance. So you all know where the reception is going to be taking place. So after this, there's going to be pictures. You guys are going to take the pictures. And the reception starts at about 5 p.m. at the venue. And usually it's our tradition to always give glory to God whenever he does something good for us. So we are inviting you on behalf of Sir and his wife to join us tomorrow. We have three services. The first is at 8 a.m., second is at 10 a.m., and the third is at 5 p.m. So they have chosen to use the second service to come and give thanks to God. So we're inviting every one of you to join us tomorrow in our second service.
Yes.
As we come, it starts at 10 a.m. They will come and have time to dance and celebrate God and give thanks to God and glorify God. Amen.
Amen.
So we're inviting you guys to come. And I was told that tomorrow evening after the service, there's going to be some powerful barbecue and somewhere there. So after the service, you guys can go and relax and have so much fun. For those of you that traveled from far and wide, from near, and wherever you had traveled from, may the Lord grant you journey mercies. May this be a sweet trip for you.
Amen.
May you never have any regret in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So I skipped all. We're supposed to have our offering time. Do you have that offering envelopes?
Yes.
Okay, please, ushers, just pass the offering envelopes. We are done. This is the last part. We're done with this. We share the goodness right now, and they dance, and then they come back for the picture. We are specially recognizing. Please, ushers, quickly pass the offering. We receive offerings. It goes back to God. Okay. We do weddings for free here. We don't charge people for wedding in our church. We don't charge them to pay anything. But every time we're in the presence of God, it's good to give. You know how much they are paying for the hall, right? You know how much they are paying. And that's the thing, that people's mind is so bad. When it's secular thing, they can give them all the money right there. But when you say give offering in church, some people are thinking, you know. So just think. And if you don't have an offering, just don't worry. The blessing will go with you. But it's smart for you to say, thank you, Lord, for this great wedding. How many of you think it was a good wedding? How many of you think we had a good time? Amen. So can we specially recognize and celebrate the father of the groom, of the bride, sorry. Prepare your offerings. Now, can we celebrate the mother of the bride, the miracle woman? Come on. Please, the mother of the groom is here. Where are you, mother? Mother, mother. Where's mother? Eh? Oh, she missed this big. Can somebody receive it for her? Woo! Who? You are receiving it from her. Mwah! Give her our love. Tell her we love her, we honor and respect her. And all of you, the brides, bridal train, right?
Yes.
The bridal train. Can you celebrate the bridal train? Woo! They all look gorgeous, except that it seems all of them are married. So single guys, you have to pray more.
Yes.
Okay. The ones that are not married, when I say celebrate the bride, you have to do it so that they can see you well. Can we celebrate the bridal train? Woo! All right. So all our fathers, our elders, everyone, we thank you so much for coming. Now, if you have that offering ready, can you lift it up? If you want to swipe your card, we have a machine. Is Minister Choma there? Is Minister Bumi there? We have a machine. You can just raise your hand if you want to give with your card, your credit card. You can either fill it up or you give. Please remember, we don't force people to give here. And all humility, we don't beg people to give here. Okay?
Amen.
So if you are giving, you give willingly and joyfully. Amen?
Amen.
All right. If you have that offering, something good, you give it. Let's give it to God. Amen. Where's my pen? All right. If you want to give with your credit card, you just raise up your hand and Minister Choma is going to come to you. That's him right there and serve you wherever you are. You just swipe your card and it's going to send you the receipt. Lift it up, please. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we command the blessings and the favor of God to rest upon everyone giving.
Amen.
Lord, your word says very clear that if we give, it will be given to us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over. Now we're using Sir and Lucy's wedding as an opportunity to honor you with an offering.
Amen.
Now let there be more than enough blessings. And every parent here that is giving, may their children have better marriages and weddings in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And everyone giving, believing you for a miracle, let there be a miracle in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Can I hear a loud amen?
Amen.
Go in peace. And may the Lord bless and prosper you in Jesus' name. Let's share the grace together. Please, let's stand to our feet if you can. This is the final stand. I'm waiting for you. Let's stand, please. Please, if mother can stand. Mother, everyone, please, in the congregation. Everyone stand. Kelvin, stand, please. We are waiting for you to stand. There are always people that we want to be a little distant. I'm waiting for everyone to stand. Where are the people there? So in the house of God, we honor and we respect God, okay?
Amen.
You don't... All right, so we have had a great time. We have had a wonderful time. As you go in peace.
Amen.
And you enjoy your life.
Amen.
May God's face shine on you.
Amen.
And may you know by experience that you've entered into the house of God.
Amen.
May the blessings that will come upon you be undeniable. Amen. And you will trace all the blessings,
yes,
to this day that you were blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's share the grace. If you know it, we'll just share. Those that don't know it, just relax. The grace. Let's go. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God,
and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit
rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you all. We love you. Now they're going to be dancing, but because of everything, since the officiating ministers are already here, can we quickly do the officiating ministers' pictures, please? It's over. So give us some heavy duty music. Make sure you greet each other. Make sure you talk to somebody. Make sure you show someone some love. And if you're waiting for the pictures, just wait for the pictures. Amen. Oh, I forgot to thank all the officiating ministers. God bless and honor you. Please, ushers, can we quickly receive the offering? If you have that offering, the ushers are there to serve you. Ushers. Ushers, please, let's be quick, fast. Drop off our offerings. Thank you very much. And please, we are asking our Church on Fire International ministers, leaders, members, or any other person that is even a guest that can wait a little bit to help us rearrange the chairs so we are ready for tomorrow. Please do that so that we don't leave all of this work for just a few people. God bless you. Let's start rearranging the chairs while we are taking pictures. Please, all the officiating ministers.